We're not talking about people's backyards. Oh, who's got this and that?
Ruben's got a secret formula that's not so secret. Gosh, it's so cold that
there's ice on the pan, the ice is in the billy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fire in the heart, fire in the belly.
Yeah, and the smoke just doesn't even want to rise up. It's so cold, it wants to stay down here near the fire.
Well, we just heard that there was a elder from Aikea walking through the country and that there's going to be a ceremony, and we don't get to experience the local culture very often, so it's a really special occasion to come and see from our local perspective what the local people do, and learn more about the spirit of the land here, our Wiradjuri land that we live in, and are very interested in the wonderful quest of walking across Australia for peace too.
And I think to see, I guess, a tradition that's been around for so many thousands and thousands of years to still be perpetuated in something that, well, has become a modern cause as well, like to see those two elements both brought together.
The ceremony was quite solemn and sacred, and I wasn't allowed to film it, so I was able to be a participant rather than a filmmaker.
Yeah, the ceremony we just had is to smoke the people of who are on this journey with Uncle Kev and give them safe passage from here through to the rest of Wiradjuri country till they get to the other people's country near Canberra, and to also cleanse their spirits of any bad spirits that they've probably picked up along the way, and that, and so the ochre was put on them to help cleanse that and give them a third eye to see the things that are hidden from our normal view. So these people are on a very special journey with Uncle Kev of carrying his sacred fire, which is also sacred to the rest of us Aboriginal people in Australia. And so it was to make the people realise a lot more how significant and how special and how privileged they are to be involved with something what he's doing, because of the sacredness of what he's doing. So that was one reason there to do that, so people realise that this is a very special thing that they're involved in. And so the smoking cleanses them of any bad spiritual things or bad spirits that have been picked up along the way.
We've just been very honoured to have been smoked by a Wiradjuri elder, and to help us on our journeys into this cut up country now, this cancer and this sickness that's in, the closer we go, further into the cities, and we've got to be strong. And so it's been really good today to have that, because we need that that support, and we need to realise what we're doing and what we're all about and stay focused, because there's a lot out there that will distract us from that. So today was really good to remind us of that. So yeah.
Well, we've just been through a ceremony, a purification ceremony to cleanse us of bad spirits and energies that we don't need anymore. And I think everyone feels refreshed and more connected to each other. I know I do.
It's crystal sparkling, what a show. Look at the Nunga flag, it crystals, and I know it's the way we should all go. What a delight, shining bright, and brothers and sisters all grinning like cheeky monkeys. We're winning, cause we're living. It's the giving of life, your divine, divine birthright. Divine, divine, high and sublime. Every time, good or bad, there is none of that, it just is. And together we can always make it through. Every color, purple, blue, red, sit by the fire. There's always a fire, there's always a fire. Hey, ay, ay.
Gratitude and basin. Yeah. Thank you, family. Yeah. Dream of the heart.